Now find a straight-back chair, put both feet flat on the floor, close your eyes, and put your right hand by your side. Bring your attention to your right hand hanging by your side. Simply notice it. Be aware of it. And feel the blood flowing down into it, and it will tingle. Now just do that. Just be aware of your hand hanging by your side. There is no need for any effort. Again, simply notice your hand hanging by your side until you find yourself not noticing it through being caught up in a daydream of thought. And when that happens, simply bring your attention back to your hand again and again. If you do this, you will begin to feel the blood flowing down into your fingertips. You are now learning how to concentrate on your hand gently. Be very, very consciously aware of your hand. Mentally shift your attention from one finger to another. Bring your attention to your first finger. Notice it tingle a little bit. Now the second finger. Now shift your attention to the third. And fourth, coming back to the first again. Just be very, very aware of each finger in turn until it feels as though the blood were flowing into it. Tingle just a little bit. Now while you're being very, very aware of your hand, shifting your attention from one finger to another, you find you can do it. Become also aware of the middle of your forehead. Now, as though you were looking through the middle of your forehead, funnel your attention also down your right arm into your hand and bring your attention to each finger in turn while you're doing that. As though you were looking through the middle of your forehead, you can also see your right hand hanging by your side, and you can almost see an outline of your hand in your mind's eye. And looking through the middle of your forehead, you'll see thoughts. And thoughts pull you in. Just stand back from those thoughts. Just stand back from the thought. Don't fight it. Just look through the middle of your forehead as if the thoughts were clouds. And funnel your attention down your right arm. Concentrate on each little finger in turn, shifting your attention from the first finger to the second finger to the third finger. And keep on looking through the middle of your forehead with your mind's eye. Stand back and see your thoughts as a television set with no picture on it, just white noise, maybe color, little colored flashes of light. As though you're looking through the middle of your forehead, funnel your attention down your right arm and be aware of the first finger and the second finger and the third finger. And if a thought pulls you in, pull back. Pull back from the thought. Now, it may happen for a few moments that you're caught up in a daydream. Just observe the thought. Just notice that you're pulled into thought. Stand back and don't get frustrated and funnel the energy down your arm and focus on each finger in turn gently. You find you can do it. It will happen many times that your thought will pull your consciousness into it. But never mind, as many times as it happens, as many times pull back, watch the thought as if you were looking at a cave, the wall of a cave. That's all. And the thoughts will disappear, dissolve, as you look down your arm and feel the blood flowing into each finger in turn, your first finger, your second finger, and so on and so forth. Keep doing this. Don't stop. Be very aware of this hand. Be very conscious of it. Feel the presence of it. Feel the blood flowing into it. Then out of this mild, warm, tingling feeling, let that hand become a vague outline in your mind's eye, the way I described it before. It is as though you can almost see or sense where your hand is without imagery. If you're using a phone, use the left hand to listen. And follow these instructions, which are very simple, without effort. No concentration is necessary, just simply do what I ask you to do. Close your eyes. Look at your eyelids. What do you see when you close your eyes and look at your eyelids? Surely there's little twinkles of light, different shapes moving across the screen of your mind. Is that so? You're not going to go to sleep. You're going to be fully aware. I just want you to look at your eyelids. Something magical happens when you observe
those little pixels, whatever you want to call them, crossing the screen of your mind. It has all different colors, little sparkles. This is programming from within. If you just do this and keep your mind just on those little twinkling lights and little colors moving across the screen of your mind, just be aware of them, and you will find that you are in a refuge, meaning you cannot see your thoughts. You can hear my voice, but you've left your thoughts behind. That's very important. This is what's happening. No effort is required for that. You have left your thoughts behind. You are separate from your thinking. You are the thinker, not the thinking. You are in a refuge. Your thoughts cannot bother you here. That's why I call it a refuge. Something also magically is happening. Is it because your mind is no longer caught up in your thought? Your consciousness becomes pure, not sullied with the emotion-based thinking. And so it becomes like a lens. And that lens is the reason why light is shining through that lens of your consciousness onto the surface of your mind. And it's beginning to be a program to you. Please do not try to understand this. It's not uncoverable. It's impossible. But it's like magic when you see what's going to happen to you after this. Everything's going to change in a good way. Now, the next thing to do while you're looking at your eyelids and watching that little display is become aware of your right hand by your side. Become conscious of the first finger of your right hand. And just being conscious of it, just being aware of it, causes a little tingle in your first finger. If you become aware of the first finger, it will answer to your awareness, and it is as if to say, I'm aware that you're aware of me. So the finger will answer the awareness with a little tingle. And that's converting energy from the mind into your body, beginning with your first finger of your right hand. And if you feel that tingle, say quietly to yourself, yes. And if so, go to the second finger, and it will do the same thing. The tingling may remain in the first finger, but you can also go to the second finger, and it will tingle also. And when it responds with a little tingle, to let you know it's there, you're aware of it, and that awareness has had an effect on it, with a new kind of energy. At that tingling is an energy from within, counter to stress energy. Now the third finger, same way, and then say yes to yourself if you feel that. And then the pinky finger, the little finger, do that too. And then the thumb, and keep doing this as I talk to you. I'm not going to say much, but I've already told you, you have a pure consciousness, unsullied by emotionally based thoughts, which is your Waterloo, if you'll excuse me saying it that way. And so something is coming in from within you, something pure and good. And when you open your eyes and look around the room, you'll see that the room is brighter. And that's all I'm going to say. If you keep doing this for a little while longer, your body may feel warm and your solar plexus may feel opening up. These things could happen, but it's not necessary for the moment. Just the tingling of your fingers, the first finger, the second finger, and the third finger, and the little finger and the thumb, and just listen to my voice so that you stay in this state for just a few minutes. All I'm going to do is have you open your eyes in this state in a few minutes, and you will find that you're immune to stress, and everything will be brighter. And you'll find that your angers and hostilities simply disappear. It's almost like something has forgiven you, and it has. And then you find you can be more forgiving and patient with everybody. Now open your eyes and look around you. And you will see that if you're sitting in a room at night, you will notice the room is brighter. And if you have problems with cigarette or smoking, or even eating, or any problems with drugs, you'll find that you won't want it. You've found the power to overcome the want to. There's a part of you that makes you want to do what you shouldn't. You want to stop smoking or drinking, but something in you that makes you want to, and you don't want to in the struggle. Don't struggle. Just follow the meditation exercise. Just a couple of times a day, that's all. Just wait and see what happens to you. I've suggested nothing. I have not spoken about God. I have maybe implied it, but not spoken about it. There's no religious language. And all you have to do is sit quietly. So when you separate from your thinking, so you become the thinker, not sullied by the thought, not caught up in the thoughts, you have reprieve. You have the means, have opened yourself to reprieve from all kinds of problems planted since you were a little boy or a little girl. Thank you for listening.